their brothers and elders. This moment in time, honestly, when we look at the conditions of Muslims globally, we cannot help but feel really disturbed, perturbed, and a bit uneasy about the condition which Muslims are currently going through. A person who says La ilaha illallah, you can't help but be moved with emotion every time you receive a picture or you see a video or you see a clip. Sometimes it just gets too much and you just want to lock it off. You know, you just want to lock it off and just turn a blind eye to the situation. But the reality is that of the reciters of Kalima La ilaha illa Muhammad Rasulullah, you can't lose hope. And we always have to try and keep focus on the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's one Mawlana, he forwarded this picture. And when you look at the picture, you just see all these like people wrapped up in these white cloths on the floor. From a distance, you'd think it's a poultry farm or something. Like, you look in a poultry farm, you just see bare chicken on the floor. This was exactly the same thing. From a distance, an aerial view, you'd think it is a chicken or something. When they zoomed in closer, it was bodies of Muslims wrapped up in their coffins. It's a painful situation that, you know, we have to see our brothers and sisters across the globe going through taklif, and wallahi, we feel helpless, man. We want to do something. What can we do? We try, you know, our amal is so bad, subhanAllah, that physically we can't move these people that are causing the zulm. But wallah, this much we everyone can do. They can be an ambassador of khair. Each and every person can be that person who tries to do something in the best possible way they can. Because it's a belief of this, of ourselves as the Ummah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he made dua to Allah, Ya Allah, never let it be such that my Ummah completely be destroyed because of famine. And when he made this dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I accepted the dua. And he made this dua, Ya Allah, please, never let it be that my Ummah, there's two particular narrations. One, he makes one dua, let it not be that my Ummah die in famine. The Prophet, Allah, he made this dua, Allah accepted the dua. The second dua was, Ya Allah, let it not be that my Ummah die as a result of becoming engulfed with water and drowned in their totality. That was also accepted. Another particular riwayat, instead of this dua, another dua Abu Sallallahu Alaihi made, Ya Allah, never let it be such that the Ummah is on such that they completely be destroyed and wiped out by an enemy. And Allah subhanAllah accepted this dua as well. There's only one dua which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not accept of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And that dua was, he said, Ya Allah, never let it be that my Ummah will fight amongst themselves. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, that dua I'm not accepting. This will happen. And it will continue to happen until the Day of Judgment. Muslims will fight Muslims. Muslims will do zulm on other Muslims. The reciters of Kalima La Ilaha Illallah will make zulm on the other reciters of Kalima La Ilaha Illallah. So when we know this will exist within the Ummah, we can't lose hope, because in totality, Muslims won't be destroyed. It can't happen. Because my belief is, whatever Allah and His Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, by the Qasam of Allah, that's haqq. And I don't care who the hell proposes otherwise. They can say what they want, propose what they want, postulate what they want, hypothesize what they want. Your opinions don't mean jack. What appears, what means to me is what Allah said and Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. That's what matters to me. But we as reciters of Kalima La ilaha illallah, we still can't help but feel wallahi really moved with what we see. Because naturally we should have concern for the Ummah.